feel low, you can still go. Even when you feel slow, you can still go. Even when there's no hope, you can still go. I never answer to no, man, I still go. Go, 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 go.
Okay guys, welcome back to my channel. This is about the Royal Enfields, as you can see. The 350, the 500 and the 650. And we have the experts and the KTM there, but those are plastics, so we'll just concentrate on metal over here.
Oh. Ouch.
I'm just trying to make your bikes look good.
Oh.
Okay, we'll start with the 350 over here. 13-year-old bike. Tell me something about your bike. First, introduce yourself to the...
Yes, so my name is Sagar. This is my first bike. I am planning to upgrade the bike for so long. But even if I upgrade the bike, I'll go with this one itself. So I treat this bike as my baby.
Is it?
Yes.
I was told by a colleague you don't treat it at all.
Not as
like
a baby though.
Oil. I mean, look at this. Look at this. Well, you treat your babe pretty rough, huh? I can see that.
So that's the highlight. Agar main isko acche se karta hu,
nahi nahi battery khatam ho gaya.
Are?
Nahi, sirf display khatam ho jata. To save battery.
Okay. You can cut it.
The good part would be that you just started on the video. How smooth it starts without even having an engine or anything.
Yes. Start. So this is basically a Honda made Royal Enfield. It's extremely reliable.
Half kickstart.
I heard you can start with your hand also. Chalu kar.
With your hand?
Arey, kick.
Chalu kar na.
Kar sakte.
You never tried this before?
Yes.
Wow. And it's not like the engine is hot. I mean, we had a half an hour halt and now we are starting the bike. So, okay. So once in a blue moon, Royal Enfield does manufacture a good bike and he's been lucky enough to have it. What is, what has been your experience with the bike?
So experience so far is good. I think agar main isko theek karta hu to maza nahi aayega. So I like this rustic look.
Yes.
That's the highlight of this bike.
This guy, in 2024, he's still using drum brakes, so that's a good thing. And he somehow stops with us, so yes. What's the top speed?
So, top speed is 110, I believe. That's my top speed.
Yes.
So, it wobbles after that, but that's alright. I mean, that's okay.
That's a feature, not
that's
a bug.
That's a feature, yes.
Yes, so this bike has kept up with us, so that's a great thing as well. And what I've heard is the reliability is top notch.
Yes.
An exception, but yes, it you can see an exception right here. You've still kept the stock headlight, everything stock, so it's just there. I mean, it's like
the oil was also quite stock until few months back.
Fill it, shut it, forget it, wala Royal Enfield, ye yaha pe hai. Then you have a Royal Enfield that has actually been taken care of. You have aux lights, and why don't you tell us something about your Royal Enfield? So how much have you spent behind her?
Don't ask that because it's on video. My wife would see that. So it's a 2017 fuel injected one. Before buying this, there were a lot of noise about it that, you know, we should not buy a fuel injected. It's not reliable, this and that.
And
so
it is
I would. The engineering is not the problem. The problem is with the technicians.
Okay.
Royal Enfield somehow keeps changing their technology very often, and the technicians, they are not able to keep up.
Okay.
So finding the problem in the bike sometimes gets challenging, especially with the electronic parts.
Hmm.
Otherwise, I have done long rides close to around 2,800, 3,000 kilometers, and it just went bombastic.
Is
no
it?
Issues at all. It's very stable. Being 500 as compared to 350, it can easily cruise at 120, 130.
Hmm.
Beyond 130, it's like, you know, literally pushing it a lot.
But easily, you're using the word easily, over 130 is the limit.
So, I would say for 500, 110 and 120 is a decent sweet spot.
Decent
100 is a sweet spot, okay. But 100, 110, 120 is good. You can just...
You can.
Yeah.
Because all the reviews that I've seen on YouTube, is they say the sweet spot is 80, 90 kilometers. You're saying 110, 120 is something that you can cruise on.
80 is when you feel that the bike is almost...
Okay.
It's not running.
Okay.
But cruising is 110, I would say.
So a true rider can ride at 110, 120 as long as it's maintained properly.
Yeah.
What I've heard is people who take these bikes to Ladakh, they actually have to carry a alternate fuel injection just in case of the...
That's the problem. Many of the people, they have converted to carburetor.
I don't
know how successful that is. Even I had been advised quite some time. I have changed my fuel pump, not the injector.
The fuel pump.
Yeah. So then there was some problem with the firing. There was some missing problem. So for that, then I changed the coil.
Okay.
And sorted the problem. But otherwise, it's like just regular cleaning and servicing.
Okay.
No other penny spent on that.
So how many kilometers then? 28,000?
28,000, close to 29,000 now.
Okay.
And I've just serviced it once with like complete overhaul.
Overhaul before the
ride. Long ride.
Yes.
I changed the bearings, I changed the push, changed obviously the oil and everything. Clutch plates have been changed only once around, that too just for the peace of mind.
Okay.
It wasn't required, but just for the peace of mind, I did around 26,000 when I rode it to Bangalore. So yes, pretty much it's a reliable bike.
So this bike has a pretty good roll-on acceleration. I mean, if you're looking from start to stop, obviously it may not be the fastest. But what matters is when you're in traffic and the traffic suddenly clears out, the roll-on acceleration is pretty decent. So that's what I really noticed about this bike.
Only problem with this is... this bike doesn't have rear brakes, so they are just for the namesake. So major dependency is on the front brakes. It doesn't have the ABS obviously, because its rear is drum and front is disc brake. But major load comes onto the front braking.
Okay.
And engine braking.
Gotcha. What's the average that you get?
On highways, I get decent of around 30, 32.
Okay.
So consistently for last 5-7 years. In cities, depends on how I'm riding, what the traffic conditions are, but somewhere around 18, 20, 25. Depending upon how the
18?
Something.
That low?
That low. 20, wow. 21, 22 is regular. It's quite normal.
18 is what his Polo gets.
Yeah.
The diesel Polo.
But then if you rev it above 4000, Atra tak aa jayega.
Atra tak, acha. And what's the average you get? Yours is a carburetor, no?
Yes.
No jhanjhat, nothing.
Nothing. So average.
Electric start bhi nahi hai, no?
Nahi, electric start bhi nahi.
Achha, absolute BS.
Yes. So average 25 tak definitely milta hai, 25-30.
25-30.
Yes, easily.
Wow.
Na milta
hai. And you're not complaining about the brakes like this guy?
नहीं, not literally, because इतना speed वो चढ़ता ही नहीं है, so
अच्छा, but at least speed का feeling आते हैं with your exhaust, so you feel as if you're 20 kilometers faster.
Yes,
so psychologically you feel okay, you're fast. But ठीक है, I mean city में where do you need that much?
Exactly. So highways पे जाना तो होता नहीं है, but just during the office time highway आता है, but that is
वो भी traffic के साथ.
Traffic के साथ ये, so patch hardly कुछ मिलता है.
Thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned for part 2.
Nice, nice. Now we'll go to the most modern Royal Enfield.
How old is she?
22. So 2022 model.
2 years.
2 years, yes.
Okay. And I can see typical Royal Enfield build quality. This is already...